had to make Pharaoh mad.
Right.
He put him in prison. And so Joseph made friends with the butler and the shepherd.
All right.
And the butler and the shepherd came to tell Joseph about a dream that they had.
And Joseph
wanted to know what the interpretation, and the butler interpreted his dream and told him about everything, how he was going to be restored back to Pharaoh's house, and how he was going to be blessed and everything. But the banker, he told him that there was going to be a bird nest on top of his head, and the bird was going to come and pick his eyes out and all the things, and he's going to be hung.
All right.
So these things came to pass. And when the butler got out, he went back to Potiphar's house. I'm fast forwarding right here. He went back to Potiphar, and Pharaoh had a dream.
All right.
And Pharaoh had a dream one night. He dreamed about seven thin cows and seven fat cows.
All right.
But his magistrates couldn't interpret the dream.
All right.
And they tried to figure out, and Pharaoh, he was determined to figure out, because he dreamed the dream twice.
Yeah.
When God gives you a dream twice, he's trying to speak to you. So Pharaoh just didn't stop. He wanted to find out what the dream was all about.
Yeah.
And so the butler, he brought back to mind. He said, "Oh, I remember.
All right.
There was a man, there was a Hebrew guy in the prison.
Yeah.
We had a dream, and we told him about our dream. He interpreted it to this day."
All right.
And then Pharaoh said, "Go fetch him out." And so they went for down and fetched Joseph out of prison. They cleaned him up. They shaved his head and brought him all in and brought him in to Pharaoh.
All right.
And Pharaoh said, "I know you a dream interpreter."
Yeah.
And Joseph recognized, "This is what we got to do. We got to get stuff out of the way." He said, "I can't do nothing unless God give it to me." So he was giving God the credit for what was happening in his interpretation of the dream. So that's what we got to do. It's God get the glory. It's God get the glory. It's not worth it.
That's right.
Favor is not fair.
Uh-huh.
But it didn't stop right there. After Joseph found out about these dreams that had been interpreted, then it comes to pass and everything, Joseph said,
Well.
Pharaoh, what his dream was all about. He said, the first 7 years of the fat cow, that's going to be plenty. That's going to be plenty. And the 7 years of corn on the stock going to be 7 years of plenty. You're going to have abundance rain over 7 years. And the seven lean cattle means 7 years of famine. There's going to be some times in our lives that we're going to have some famine times in our lives. There's going to be some times that we're going to lose some stuff in our lives, these famine times. But God gave us a penance year in order to take us to the famine year. So we got to always put something back for the hard times that are coming. You know, so that's why we give God his 10% and we keep our 10%. And God will bless that 10%. But we put in the 10%, and we won't be in the bank.
Let it go.
Joseph.
Well.
This started after he interpreted the
dreams
of Pharaoh. Pharaoh saw everything was good.
All right.
He blessed Joseph, and he made him ruler over all the land in Egypt.
All right.
He put a gold chain about his neck.
All right.
He put a ring on his finger.
Right.
He made Joseph the second in command to him.
Yeah.
He told everybody, if anybody mess with Joseph, they're going to have to mess with him.
Right.
Favor ain't fair. Right. You know, so Joseph was raised up in the rest. So we're just going to fast forward on to the story right here. I'm just trying to set y'all and get y'all to see where we're going at. We're all a family.
All right.
We got families, we got children, we got grandchildren.
Yeah.
And sometimes things in our family happen.
Right.
This particular time, there was a death in the family.
All right.
When the center position of the family is taken out, then people get to looking around saying, what we gonna do? Mama done died, what we gonna do? Dad is gone, what we gonna do? I ain't got brother no more, what we gonna do? When the center position is taken out of your life, what you gonna do? We'll find out right here that the brothers found out that their dad was dying. And they knew that long as Jacob was living, they was covered under his protection.
Yes, sir.
Since
yes,
Joseph wouldn't bother them.
Yes,
but we find out here in a particular text where we find out that Joseph was saying,
All right.
He said, the next is sending to him, he said, so shall Joseph forgive.
All right.
We got to forgive.
Yes,
we holding on to stuff for years. They took their hell on to that for 22 years. If you look at the time span between when Joseph was taken into captivity and to the time that when Pharaoh made him ruler over all the land, Joseph was 30 years old.
Yeah.
And then that also, there was 7 more years of famine, so that made the 37 years that Joseph was old. And then the second year that when he met his brother.
Yeah.
That means that they was in the second year of the famine. That means Joseph was 39 years old when he met his brothers after 22 years.
Yes, sir.
22 years before they had seen their brother.
Right.
And when they did see their brother, they didn't even recognize him.
Right.
You know, 22 years can make a lot of change in somebody's life. And for 22 years, you want to hold on to some stuff for that long. And I believe some people holding on to things for 50 and 60 years and won't let it go. Is it worth it? Let it go. Is it worth it?
Yeah.
Let it go. But we find right here in this particular table, we got forgiveness in this situation. Joseph had forgiveness from the day that he first saw his brother. And we find here in the 50th chapter where they talk about forgiveness, and Joseph already had forgiven them when he first met them, when he gave them pillows, and when he gave provision to them, and when he put their money back in their bag and sent them back to their father with more than they had before when they came. So that lets me know that was a forgiving spirit. You know, a forgiving spirit, even though Joseph was hurt from what his brother did to him, and he wanted to teach them a lesson by not telling them who he was and going back to find out if he could be trusted. Sometimes you have to be checked to see whether or not you can be trusted. Once you done me a fuckful kind of way, you done put the foot on me and you done backstab me, now I got to see whether or not I can trust. So those who are doing him right now, we will see whether or not he can trust his brother once again. We must forgive. We know that. Forgiveness. In Matthew's Gospel, chapter 6, it talks about forgiveness. And he said, if thy brother forgive thy brother. And Jesus said, 7 times 7. That means as many times as it takes, we should forgive one another. You know, forgiveness will stop your blessing. Forgiveness will hinder you from getting what God has for you. Forgiveness will take you to the grave. Forgiveness will make you sick. Give forgiveness. If you don't forgive, guilt on the inside will eat you up. So that was forgiveness also. So we go on a little bit further. And we find out that Joseph told him, said, in verse 19, said, fear not. Fear. There's another weapon of Satan. Fear will keep us from asking for forgiveness. Fear will keep us from doing what God has called us to do. Fear will keep us from having what God has blessed us to have. Fear will clog our conscience, our think, our thought. Fear will cause us not to say, I forgive you, sir. Fear will cause us to say, I don't forgive you because I'm afraid, I'm fear for what they would do to me. Joseph's brother feared him for what they would do to him, what he would do to them. Sometimes we have fear for being frightened. Fear of knowing about a grief. Fear of knowing about a situation. You know, how is this job going to turn out? Am I going to get this job? You'll be fearful, whatnot. It's a good fear, it's a bad fear. Am I going to get this job? Am I going to have this job? Anxiousness. You know, anxiousness and guilt. Woo! Let me tell you something a little about guilt. Guilt, man. Fear will eat on guilt just like a man eating on a piece of cornbread. And work that thing. It'll work to have you thinking, and you'll be suspicious of everybody. You think he know about that? I ain't seeing you, but we be suspicious when guilt is in our heart. But when God do forgive, and that goes back to still because all these things happen. Let it go. And let go. We find that Joseph had to let go of things, but he just didn't stop there. He said, but God, but they thought it for evil. But God did it for the good. God will take a bad situation and turn it to a blessing. You know that God took Joseph enough. He made a good situation out of it. Even though he was thrown in the pit, he didn't stay in the pit. He was brought out of the pit. He was cooking down to Egypt. But he was taken out of a pit that had no water in it. He was sold to the Egyptians. Anger towards our even our kids. We need to let some of that stuff go. We hold this stuff in which way. You done that, let that stuff go. When we let it go, is it worth it losing our loved ones? Is it worth it losing a relationship with someone that you love? Is it worth losing the separation of a family? Is it worth it?
Well,
let it go. Come on, we be mad at one another for no reason at all. Just because of what he got on. Just because of what she got on. Let it go. Let it go and let God. God will bless you at the same way he blessed us. But when you got favor with God, it is the unmerited grace that God has spread upon our lives. God's grace, it doesn't stop there, but we got favor when Jesus Christ came.
Yes, sir.
You know, he begins to bring a new commandment into the world. Believe in me. Accept me as your Lord and Savior. He shouldn't live forever. Let it go and let God have it. Let it go. We are forgiven for all our pains and all our sorrows. When we let it go, we don't have to worry about it no more. We can lay down at night and we can have that rest. Let it go. If you don't want to shut the man's hand, you gotta let that thing go.